Welcome. My name is Ali Azarbayejani. I got my PhD here in the Media Lab with a previous incarnation of Sandy's group when we were doing 3D computer vision and things like that, visual interactions with people. In the meantime, since I graduated, Sandy's done some seminal work on social signaling and on mobile device behavior. And those are some of the intellectual ideas behind the technology of our company. I'm currently the CTO of Cogito Corporation and one of the founding members of the current team. Sandy's also a founder of the company and is on the board as well. And he's the original visionary for the company, for the technology for the company. So I want to tell you a little bit about our company and how we've leveraged the intellectual ideas to build technologies and products to help organizations. So our company was founded about 7 years ago with the big idea that we could collect behavioral data and provide a new source of data and objective measures to help organizations improve outcomes and ultimately their bottom line. And in particular, we were looking at organizations who are responsible for managing large populations, like care management companies, who before Cogito had very little insight into the data about, or into their populations and about the interactions in with their populations, while at the same time, their performance and their ability to do their jobs really depended heavily on understanding their population and understanding how they could improve interactions with their population. So that was the big idea of the company, and it's based on a couple of ideas that were worked on heavily here at the Media Lab, including social signaling and speech. So a lot of what you communicate when you're in a conversation is not what you say, but how you say it. So to understand a little bit about how the technology works there, imagine listening to a conversation between two people in a foreign language that you don't understand. You may not understand the words or the topic of the conversation, but you still can understand a lot of what's going on in the conversation. You can tell whether people are happy or angry, you can tell whether they're interested or bored, and you can tell whether they're in agreement or disagreement, all these sorts of things. And that's in a nutshell what our technology is doing and providing in a quantified digital way to our clients. The second technology of behavioral signals has to do with mobile devices. And you know, increasingly, mobile devices are becoming our constant companions. And a lot of our social interactions and our daily activities are done with our cell phone and through our cell phone. If your cell phone were smart enough, if you wanted to know, or if my cell phone were smart enough, if you wanted to know how I was doing, you could just ask my phone, because a lot of the information about my sleep, activity, social interactions, and mood can be inferred from the information that's on my phone. And so the big idea here is seeing if we can leverage that to create a new mode of healthcare interaction where we can get more sort of continuous information between office visits about how people are doing, particularly in psychological health. So I'll explain how that fits into our product and our company. So our company has developed a platform of technology with three principal interfaces. The first one is called Cogito Dialogue, and that's a real-time interface for agents in call centers to give them real-time feedback on the interaction that they're having right now. And it can help them with a variety of things, which I'll show you. The second interface is called Cogito Central, and that is intended as an interface, both a real-time interface and a historical interface to the data that can help various people in the organization understand what's going on throughout a call center, throughout the organization, throughout the population that they're managing, quantify it, get some insights, and understand how to improve interactions. And the third interface is the mobile phone, which is an interface for users who want to participate in a system where they can be part of a support network and also get some feedback that'll help them with self-awareness, self-care on their conditions. So let's look a little bit at Cogito Dialogue. This system is installed in call centers of some major healthcare operations, and agents are finding it useful for understanding customer engagement and distress levels, understanding their agents' own behavior and interaction so that they can improve that. And it also provides a platform for providing alerts and notifications when there's some action that it might be useful for an agent to take. Here are two very different conversations and what they look like to the agent. This interface gives the agent a picture of the conversation that they're having right now. And in this upper picture, you see a conversation with a healthcare member who may be not engaged or in some context might be a depressed patient. You can see that the conversation is very disjointed and there isn't a lot of participation on the part of the patient, even though it looks like the agent is putting forth a lot of efforts to create some engagement. On the bottom is a very different conversation where there's a lot more flow to the conversation. It's a lot more continuous conversation with good turn-taking and good participation on both sides. So it's this kind of picture that the agent sees in real time in the call center and helps them understand what's going on in the conversation and what they can do to make the conversation better. As I mentioned, this is our major focus right now is in the healthcare industry, but you can imagine that in the near future, any call center agent would want to have a real-time picture of what they're doing, and this will eventually be on everyone's desktop who's a call center agent. Of course, the data here is all digital and quantified, and can be collected and used, both in real time and as a historical record of interactions that have gone on the call center. So it gives a quantitative basis for analyzing how we're doing, what insights can we get from this about our business, and how can we improve things. Cogito Companion is the mobile interface, and this is in an earlier stage of development. This year we ran a clinical trial where we had participants who have been diagnosed with depression and/or PTSD, and the goal of this study was to collect data to see if we can do prediction of these symptoms in a more continuous way that would enable a new way for these patients to interact with the healthcare system, which is more continuous and more opportunistic, so that they can get care and support when they need it, rather than being driven by periodic office visits. An interesting thing about the clinical study we did, it was here in Boston in the first half of this year, and the Boston bombing that happened at the marathon in April happened right in the middle of our study. So we have a very interesting data set that we're going to analyze. We've already seen some initial results of changes in behavior that happened shortly after that bombing with some of our participants. So the mission of Cogito is a number of things, starting with better agent engagement skills and decision making in real time, which we provide with the Cogito dialogue interface. And then supervisor tools for delivering targeted coaching and training, and also organizational wide analysis of interactions and predicted outcomes that can drive understanding of high risks and high value interventions that can improve the effectiveness of these organizations with their populations. And finally, providing tools for improved member self-care and self-management through these mobile devices and interaction with support networks. And what our goals are here are increased engagement between these organizations and their populations, improved outcomes, particularly in the healthcare arena, and increased productivity. So that's in a nutshell Cogito Corporation and what we're doing with the technology of social and behavioral signaling. Thank you.